2019 Gatorade National Athlete of the Year Awards here with Jasmine Moore of Texas.
Yes.
Jumper extraordinaire. And our girls athlete of the year for track and field. Mm-hmm. First off, how's the first day been here in Southern California?
It's been really fun, and we've had some really awesome things that were planned for us, and just meeting all the other athletes and their sports is just really crazy, and then seeing all the film that they've done with us. It's just been an awesome time so far.
When did you first become aware of the Gatorade National Award? Not so much winning it this year, but when did you first become aware of something like this for the high school level?
I think my sophomore year, because my dad, my coach, they had nominated me my sophomore year, but then I didn't get it. And then last year I won for Texas.
Right.
And then I've just been watching the videos of all the other athletes in the past, and I've always wanted to win this award, so for me to finally get it is kind of so great.
Did you think you had much of a chance? I know it's a very, very strong.
I know.
Girls track and field is just so loaded this year, especially.
Mm-hmm.
What would you think? Do you think your chance was pretty strong, or
yeah.
Were you not pushing yourself?
I mean, you never want to count yourself out. So I'm like always hoping that I had got it. But like you said, it's so strong and there's so much depth. So I didn't know, but my dad was like, because he knew before me, so while I was over here stressing out about it, he was like, just stay calm. And then I got it, so yeah.
And success in both long jump and triple jump. We've had some girls have been phenomenal in one or the other. Your prowess in both has been really, really impressive. Unprecedented in a sense, really.
Mm-hmm.
What should be the key to that? The key to that is what do you think?
Just like you can't let one slack. You kind of have to just give both the same amount of love and, you know, go in at both. Because although like triple jump is my better event, I still want to be successful in long jump and I still want to be able to help my team out in long jump. So for me, that's a big deal, and just being successful in both. So of course, I'm going to always practice and just give both the same together.
Obviously, track and field in Texas is no joke. It's
yes.
Very, very strong here.
Yeah.
But now it's just another huge step because the NCAAs is mega loaded.
Yes.
How do you approach that challenge, the next level?
The same way I kind of did my freshman year in high school. At first I was really nervous just because of all the girls that were seniors and stuff. But then again, a lot of the girls in college I've competed against whenever I was in high school, whenever they were in high school. So it's kind of the same deal, but at a bigger stage, and I'm just going to go in there hungry and ready and then just do my best and work hard and not to slack at all, just so I can just help my team and then just grow as an athlete as much as I can.
Is the approach to go ahead and try and still work on both, or not work on both, actually compete at both next level, or focus more on one?
No, compete at both and best, both next at the next level, and then just do my best in both. I want to be able to score points and help my team out and just PR and just grow as an athlete in both events.
As exceptional as you've been in both of the events over the years, and this year obviously some really big marks as well, what are your goals your first year going on into college?
To score as much as I can at NCAAs, and then I would love to win. And just mainly it's just to keep my grades up and have fun and just be surrounded by people that all have the same goals as me. I think it will be very fun and very exciting.
How daunting is it, if it is, at the next level where you've got so many people all around you that are going to be phenomenal level? I mean, as it is, obviously, we mentioned Texas is very strong, but it's going to be everywhere now.
Yeah.
How exciting is that? How daunting is that?
I think it's really exciting because first off, I've never really had a training partner, so for me to have training partners that are going to make sure I'm on top of it every single day of practice, I think will be very beneficial to me. And then just knowing that every week I'm going to have someone that's going to push me at a different meet because we're going to travel all across the country. So I think it's really exciting, and I think it will be very beneficial for me and help me grow in the sport.
Were there any major challenges you may have had this year that you really had to overcome?
Definitely I switched my arms this year. I used to be double arm, and I switched it to single arm just because I knew my freshman year of college, Coach Pedro was wanting to switch me, so I was trying to get an early start to it. So for me, that was a little bit scary just because it was my senior year, and of course you want to do your best, and I didn't know how my training and how I was going to perform with the new technique. So that was a little bit iffy for me, but other than that, just always having confidence for me is kind of hard, so...
How has that been for you, making that change?
Like I said, it was kind of scary at first just because I didn't know how I was going to jump, if I was going to do worse, or that was my biggest fear. I didn't want to get worse than how I was in the past, but I jumped more consistent this year, and although I did a PR, I think I became a better jumper by switching.
What did you learn about yourself this year? Anything in particular? From a competitive standpoint?
Yeah, that you always have to be on go. Don't ever slack, because someone is always there, and it is way harder. Like this year, it was hard being a senior because you have all the freshmen and sophomores and juniors, and they don't care. I remember what it was like being there and then watching the seniors. Like, I didn't care if they were a senior or not. I was going to try to do my best. So I feel like being a senior was kind of hard because that's worse, getting beat by underclassmen. So, yeah, but it did happen to me, and it was a very learning experience, and I'm very happy it happened. And just stay on go at all times.
So now you're here for the big week, like in the next few days. So far, you see some of these big names in sports at the next level around you. What's it been like, and what do you hope to take away from this week?
It's very motivating just to know that you see everyone else doing good, and it makes you just want to do good too. So just meeting all the other athletes, and they're bomb in their sports. They're doing amazing. So just seeing everyone, meeting everyone, it's very exciting, and it just motivates me to keep on going.
Who's your big, the person you look up to most in track and field, and probably the person you're most in awe of outside of track and field in the sports world?
I look up to, let me see. Well, Couture Orji is one of them. She went to the University of Georgia, and I just think she's such a great person and a great athlete, and she won the Bowerman, which is amazing. So she's definitely someone I look up to, and is the reason why I chose University of Georgia. And then I guess someone I look up out to, I mean, outside of track.
Anybody here?
I'm trying to think, because I know whenever this interview's over, I'm going to be like, oh, I should have said that person. That's what's going to happen. But,
Okay, well, this week, hopefully you really enjoy it. And congratulations on Gatorade Track and Field Girls Athlete of the Year, Jasmine Moore of Texas.
Thank you.